video about the frequently asked questions in midrine, and here first we will see there are two parts. Okay, one is at the level of the superior colliculus, another one is at the level of the inferior colliculus. So the student should know colliculus means there are two pairs. Okay, these are called as corpora quadrigemina. Quadri means four. Okay, so superior colliculus and inferior colliculus. And I have already told you in the medulla there are four cranial nerves, 9, 10, 11, 12. And in the pons, 5, 6, 7, 8. And above that in the midbrain you have only 2, 3 and 4. Okay, so now 3 and 4. Among 3 and 4, 3 is on the top, 4 is at the bottom. So I have told you two colliculus, one is superior, another one is inferior. So obviously the superior colliculus is for the third nerve and inferior colliculus is for the fourth nerve. First you should keep it in mind. Second component, first we'll see that red nucleus. You can see something red. So red nucleus, the most important extrapyramidal structure. Okay, number one, red nucleus. Number two, why it is red in color? Because it has rich vascular supply and iron containing iron pigments are there, that's why it is red in color. And third MCQ is name the nerve passing through the red nucleus, that is your oculomotor nerve. You can see very well here. So oculomotor, so obviously this yellow color is oculomotor nucleus. So whenever you know about, you read about the oculomotor nucleus, you should know about the Edinger-Westphal component. It means the parasympathetic component of the oculomotor nucleus also. So this is about that. And the next one, if you come down, you can see the red nucleus. From the red nucleus, the fibers are crossing over. It means decussation. So that is called rubrospinal tract. It decussates. Okay, that is called ventral tegmental decussation. Like that, just above that, you will be having another one decussation, that is called dorsal tegmental decussation. First, before that, you should know there are two parts in the midbrain, like we saw in the pons. Basilar part and the tegmental part. Here you have two parts, one is called tegmental part down and this is called tectum. This upper one is called tectum. Okay, so these two are there, and the other components are, so I was talking about the rubrospinal. Rubro means red nucleus. From the red nucleus the fibers are coming out to the spinal cord, so it is called rubrospinal tract. They decussate and forms the rubrospinal tract. Decussation is called as ventral tegmental decussation. Okay, over that, above that, you will be having another decussation, that is called dorsal tegmental decussation, that is by the tectospinal tract. Okay, so these two are MCQs, and red nucleus is MCQ, and red nucleus is control, for function of red nucleus is it controls the flexor muscle tone. Okay, flexor muscle tone, three are there for the red nucleus. And the number four is your crest cerebri. In that crest cerebri only you have all the fibers, frontopontine fibers, temporopontine, parietopontine, or from all the cerebral cortex, all over the cerebral cortex the fibers are coming down to the pons. They travel through this area only. This is called as crest cerebri, right? Okay, corticospinal fibers also, they pass through this only. That is your corticoponto. One fiber is going to the cerebellum, another one is going down as corticospinal fiber. Okay, so that is crest cerebri. Basically it contains corticospinal fibers. And then next to that, there are two lines above the crest cerebri. They are called as that space in between, that is your substantia nigra. So substantia nigra, that generates dopamine, and that is very important thing. If that area is depleted or degenerated, that will lead to Parkinsonism. Okay, that is one of the extrapyramidal syndrome. Parkinsonism is the extrapyramidal disease. And then these four are the lemnisci. So you're having the medial lemnisci, spinal lemnisci, lateral lemnisci, all the lemnisci. But here we are talking about the superior colliculus. Superior colliculus MCQ is, it is for vision. Visual reflex pathway is going through that only. So superior colliculus is for vision, and these are the four important. Another one important thing I have written, this is written as mesencephalic nucleus of midbrain. Okay, that is trigeminal nerve. So trigeminal nerve, already I told you there are three components. One is motor component, another one is sensory component, and the third is mesencephalic. Already we discussed about the motor and sensory in the pons. So only component, mesencephalic component of trigeminal nerve is situated in the midbrain, that is MCQ. And then already I told you Edinger Westphal nucleus is a parasympathetic component, oculomotor. So that is, will also be present here only. So these many MCQs are there in this place. So red nucleus, ventral tegmental decussation, oculomotor nerve and Edinger Westphal nucleus, mesencephalic nucleus, superior colliculus for vision. So you have seen everything. Okay, now next one, go above. So this is superior colliculus level. Actually, first we should talk about the inferior colliculus and then superior colliculus like that. Now, inferior colliculus, it means the fourth nerve. Okay, fourth nerve is down. So inferior colliculus, here you will be having the trochlear nerve. Look at the difference between the oculomotor and trochlear. Oculomotor is coming anteriorly, but the trochlear is going back posteriorly. So this is the only cranial nerve exit in the dorsal root, okay, dorsal side, okay, dorsally, and it decussates before comes out from the midbrain. Okay, so these two are the important MCQs regarding the trochlear nerve. Number three, here you will be having some crisscross fibers here also decussation, that is the decussation of the superior cerebellar peduncle. And then here you have the four lemnisci. Okay, medial lemnisci, spinal lemnisci, lateral lemnisci. Since it is inferior colliculus, it is for hearing. So we have reached here. So inferior colliculus is a level, inferior colliculus is down and superior colliculus is above. So here we have an important MCQ. So lateral lemnisci, I said cochlear fibers only, they form the lateral lemnisci. It means hearing. So hearing stops at the level of inferior colliculus. So when you draw the superior colliculus, you are not supposed to draw the lateral lemnisci, because lateral lemnisci ends here itself. Okay, so it is going only for inferior colliculus, because inferior colliculus only receiving the fibers of hearing, not the superior colliculus. So whenever you draw the superior colliculus section, you are not supposed to draw the lateral lemnisci. That is the only difference between these two. And then red nucleus with the oculomotor section only you have to draw. So these are all the few MCQs about this. Then two syndromes we have to concentrate, that is your Benedict syndrome and Weber syndrome. So Weber syndrome is down this one, okay, where we have shaded in black in color. So here oculomotor nerve is there. How do you identify? This is a red nucleus, so this is your oculomotor nerve. So oculomotor nerve is involved and crest cerebrae is involved. So oculomotor is third nerve lesion. Okay, so you will be having the lateral squint, because medial movement will not be possible. So you will be having the lateral squint, and the next corticospinal fibers are involved. So you will be having hemiplegia, contralateral hemiplegia. This is your Weber syndrome. Keep it in mind, it looks like a W, so you can keep it like that. Okay, Weber's. And Benedict's, how to keep it in mind? So here oculomotor nerve is involved, red nucleus is involved, next to medial, that it extends outwards. So there your medial lemnisci is also there, so that is also involved. So how to keep it in mind? Benita is a girl, Benny, so that is Benedict's, and she is having squint. So squint is because of the involvement of oculomotor. She is having tremors because of the red nucleus involvement, and she is having proprioception, loss of proprioception is also there for her. She is not able to feel the position sense, joint sense, vibration sense. Okay, so you keep a story and keep it in mind. So Benita means immediately red color Benita. You should keep it in mind, red color Benita. Red color Benita, red color Benita. If you keep it in mind, red color Benita, red color means red nucleus, definitely the next moment you will think about the oculomotor nerve. Next moment you will be thinking about your medial lemnisci. So this is how you have to keep it in mind while going for competitive exams. Okay, so this is about the midbrain. That's all.